I get that nickname. I'm just kidding. Well, I started out with, like, death metal, so I didn't want to take it seriously at all. So I thought the name Big Chocolate was a very appropriate name for my small, skinny, white stature and appearance. I thought, how can I take anyone with the name Big Chocolate? I don't know why I keep flipping around. There's just a bunch of stuff happening.
It's distracting.
And I feel like talking about the name Big Chocolate, maybe the feel of Big Chocolate is going to be. There's another Big Chocolate beatboxer that I found out about. Started metal. I got started doing. I'd play drum and bass and dubstep now. Make it, play it. I don't really live it, but I sure do make it enough to where I live it. So I guess I do live it. Anyways, I got started because I remixed a band called Suicide Silence, and then started a project with the vocalists making like metal, industrial, glitched up stuff, and then I got turned on to drum and bass and dubstep to make it heavier, and just, that's the cool elements. And then, what do you know? Now I make it full on, and I just kept the name Big Chocolate, and now I face that question in every interview, and I don't have a good answer for it. That's the worst part about that name. I don't have a good answer for the question in the interviews. Right now, I just did a remix for Breathe Carolina, the new single Blackout, and that is my favorite song to play live. It's also like right in the middle of my set, so it's like a little hyped up. Another song I'm playing live is High Lion, featuring Grease. Grease is a rapper on the Edge World 2 as well, so he comes out and plays it live, and it's like, it's just fun. It's fun to have someone come out with a guest in the end, you know what I'm saying? Slipknot, Limp Bizkit, Sting, Rage Against the Machine is always a big favorite. There's a drum and bass group called Noisia, who's a huge influence of mine that I would love to feel a little nervous to work with. So, I don't know, I like new metal a lot. It doesn't really have anything to do with drum and bass. I think it'd be cool to collaborate with some like big new metal guys. So, like, not Rage Against the Machine. I'm not very athletic. I go nuts, but I'm not very athletic, so I don't run out of breath really easy. But I'll keep going nuts, so like, there's parts where I'll jump over the crowd and stuff. And sometimes I want to get back on stage. Like, the stage manager will pick me up and throw me on stage, which is nice. So now I have a jam. Like, the first few shows, I was just like, I didn't know what to expect. I didn't know he was going to throw me on stage. And there was one time where I couldn't get back up. That was this combination of me being really small and scrawny and not really being able to do it and just exhausted. It's also the last time I did some extra time. But yeah, that's probably the most embarrassing thing that's happened on this tour so far. But I don't really think it's that embarrassing. I'm perfectly confident in my non-confident self. Does that make sense? Sting. I'm a huge Sting fan.
So, good old-fashioned Looney Tunes. Never go wrong with that.
I see if I can be back up.